So good morning, everyone. We'll start with this particular session where we'll be trying to use LaTeX. Some of you have mentioned that you're not able to download it. I'll tell you what is the problem. You might be facing it. Okay, so you can do it later. But if you want to practice the same with me as of now here itself, I'll show that option also. So basically, your LaTeX as a whole consists of two parts. One is used for actually compiling the, let me say, set of lines that you write, and another is actually for editing it. Okay. So this is again compatible for both your Mac as well as for your Windows. Okay. So you have something that is called as TextMaker, which I've shared the link with Daniel sir, and he has shared it with you. So TextMaker is basically an editing software. So you'll be able to find both these things over here. But before you're going to install this particular TextMaker, you should install this particular software, MikTeX. So MikTeX is basically a software which is used for compiling the set of programs that you have written. Okay, so first you should be downloading this particular software, MikTeX. So again, you have it for Windows, Mac, Linux, etc., etc. So here, if you go to all downloads in the link that I have provided to you, then you'll be able to find a list of other, you know, set of packages. So this is a little bit different. I think you should have downloaded exactly only from Windows. Some of you might be using 32-bit system, and some of you might be using 64-bit system. Okay, so depending upon that, you can just go to all downloads over here, and then you'll be able to find various sets. So this is for a Windows 64-bit system, and then you have again two options, 64-bit and 32-bit. Apart from that, you have net installer and a basic installer. Ensure that you don't use both these things. Go for MikTeX setup utility. So that will be giving you a much better, you know, compiling option. Sometimes for some people, very rarely, this will have an issue. You might not be able to install it. And even sometimes if you install it, this will have some issues. If you have issues, then you go for net installer. Basic installer is very, very basic. If you're going to write to a journal or even to a book chapter, this might be a little bit difficult. Okay, so please ensure that you're going to use setup utility. If it fails, if it's not working, then you please go for net installer. Once you install this particular MikTeX, then you go to TextMaker, download it, and then install it. Okay, so this is where this is how you should be doing it. Still, if a problem do exist, just Google what is your problem, because certain systems will have certain issues. Okay, most of the time it will work, but sometimes it may fail off. If it is failing off, again, as I told you, you can mail it to me or you can just Google it. 100% you'll be able to get the answers. So I hope some of you might have installed it. Some of you again will have issues in the same. If that is the case, you can practice it online. Okay, there's something that is called as sharelatex.com. So this is an online platform wherein you can basically, you know, work on your LaTeX and then extract the PDF. So once you work on LaTeX, what happens is you will not be getting a document. Everything that you get out of it will be a PDF. Okay, so you can either make a document PDF or a presentation PDF. Both these things are feasible when you're using the LaTeX document. So sharelatex is one platform wherein you can generate a PDF out of your LaTeX without installing in your system. Okay, but the major problem is this is free for sure, but if you are using the free version, the documents that you type is on the public platform. Okay, so which means if you're going to write in a write a journal using the sharelatex, it will be in the public platform where other people, if they find. Finding it might be difficult, but if they find it out, obviously they can steal your work, modify it, and then do it. Okay. And again, if you want to purchase it, that is also available. You can purchase it. So I'll show that to you also. So the first time you get into the sharelatex.com, first thing you have to do is register. Okay. So already I've registered. I do have an account. Once you have registered, then you can log in directly. and then you can use it without any problem. Okay, so I have been using this, but I've been using this exclusively only for preparing my class notes. I have not used it anything apart from it. And sometimes if I give this as a project to students also. So some students will be doing some project and they have to submit a report. So generally I tell them to submit a report using this particular LaTeX. Okay. Another thing that is possible is if you're using Overleaf, there is an option which is almost like Google Drive. You can share your document with the other person. So that is the reason why I tell my project students whom I guide to type something over here and then share it with me, right? So this is one platform where it is completely available to you in the online mode, right? So again, this is your wish. So as of now, if you want to practice it, you can get to this Overleaf. And if some of you have installed it, this is how it will be looking, okay? And of course, as I told you, the layout will vary. For Mac system, it will be entirely different. And if you're using Windows or Ubuntu, Windows and Ubuntu will almost look same to same. But for Mac, it will be a little bit different. But this is how the general overview will look like, right? So here you can find something I've typed, document class, use package, etc., etc. So that is where basically you type everything, okay? And similarly, on the right hand side, if you find it, you'll be able to find a plain white kind of, you know, paper like look is there. That is where your document will be basically executed, or that is where you can display your document, right? So as I told yesterday, this will be a little bit tough. Again, sorry for repeating it, but as I told you, I'll try to give the maximum thing that is feasible within this 1 hour. But as I promised yesterday, both Word as well as LaTeX, I'll prepare a YouTube video. I can share it with you through Daniel sir. That will have an entire detailed you know, overview of how to use your Word as well as your LaTeX document. And please stop me in between if you think I'm going a little bit fast, or if you're stuck in any place between, right? So shall I start with it, or is it okay that you know, like you want to get into this Overleaf and then you know, you want to practice with me? If that is the case, we'll wait for another 2 minutes or so and then we'll do it, right? So in the question session, one person has asked, what is the purpose of using LaTeX? Nothing. You can do it using your Word document, or you can use your LaTeX document. It's not going to make a very big difference, but I remember telling this in the previous class yesterday. When you have a very large document, that's what I told. I prepared my entire thesis using my LaTeX. Reason is, if you have too many number of figures, which is in the case of thesis, and let's say n number of tables. Obviously, what happens is, if you are using Word, you try it out, 100% guaranteed. You will actually, you know, like the Word will slow down. And sometimes, you know, abruptly some images will be deleted. You think it will be deleted. If you scroll down, scroll up and down, then it will be appearing. Okay. So this will happen when you're using a Word document. If you're compiling or formatting a very large document. Another thing which is present in, you know, LaTeX is, if you have to make a small correction, you don't have to rework it from the beginning. You have to just add in a few things in between, the whole document will be changing entirely, right? And another thing is there. This is where LaTeX becomes very, very important to know about LaTeX. Most of the journals, okay, you get into any high impact fan journals, the best way of, you know, formatting your document is using LaTeX. So this is again from my experience. For others it may change, but as far as my experience is concerned, most of the reputed journals have given the LaTeX document in let me say in the official page itself. You don't have to rework anything. You just have to download that particular LaTeX format, just copy and paste whatever you have typed in your Word document. Just like that, it'll be over, because all those, you know, reputed journals want to minimize the work that is given in formatting. So that is the reason why LaTeX has an upper edge when you look into your word. Of course, word template is also given, but most of the reputed high impact journals will have LaTeX as its background. Okay, fine. So I'll simultaneously use both the installed software, and I'll also show how it goes in this particular Overleaf also. Okay, so I think I've spoken for 2 to 3 minutes. So I hope that you have created an Overleaf document so that you can work on it. Okay, so once you get into your Overleaf document, the first thing is new project. Okay, so once you click new project, and here Overleaf has an upper edge, online mode. Yeah? So it has an upper edge. So it will be asking whether I should go for a blank project, example project, or if you have a project which is readily available. I've told you it can be shared with another person, right? So if you have to share it with another person, I can go for upload project, wherein he'll make the changes, and then and that will be reflecting it. Okay. Then there's something that is called as GitHub. So people from computer science will be knowing about this GitHub. It is actually a repository where people pull in their program. It can be Python, LaTeX, R program, whatever it is. So it is just a repository where you have all those things. If you want, you can import it from there also. And this is what I told you. If you are going to publish in any academic journals, this is available. Okay, academic journal, you can find it over here. This is available. I'm not going to use this, but I'll show. So once you click this academic journal, now we can see what are the journals that are present over here. Okay. Sometimes, as I told you, you'll be able to find it very easily. Okay. SIP journal, Wiley journals, Universal. And if you are from the engineering background, most of it, go for Scopus based or IEEE based. So all these things will be there. Okay. But this again is for usage. Later also, I'll tell you how this will work. So as of now, I'm just going to go for new projects and I'll choose blank project. Okay. So as usual, you have to give a name. I'll say video session. So obviously it will be taking some time to load. Right. So now we can see this particular, lineup is almost similar to this particular lineup. Okay. I cannot show it, parallelly because that will confuse you a lot. So here again, you have something on the left hand side with all the, basically where you're going to type, and on the right hand side, you're going to view it. Online mode also will have the same thing. Okay. So you're going to have something on the left hand side where you're going to type, and this particular one, okay, on the right hand side is basically where you're going to get your, output. Okay. So what I'm going to do as of now is I'm not going to look into the installed software. I'll just use the online, share LaTeX, do some documents. Then I'll copy whatever I've written in this particular share LaTeX, just paste it in the software that I've installed in my system. Then you'll be able to see both work simultaneously the same. Nothing is going to change, right? Fine. So we'll use this share LaTeX document as a whole. Fine. So before I continue, whether you have any doubt, if there's any doubt, let me just clarify it, and then we'll get back to the proceedings.
Sir?
Yes?
Sir, is there a compulsory to have a programming knowledge to handle this software?
No, sir. Not at all. Basically, even if you're going to learn programming, this is not programming at all, but even if you're going to learn programming, the only thing is you should know what you're going to do it. So if you just Google it, it'll tell you what should be typed so that whatever is, desired, you can go for it. Okay. So the only thing is, and as you ask, the answer is no. Very simple, no. You don't have to have any knowledge about programming. A few things you have to remember. Once you remember that, then you can do it. But it's not programming background. A few things has to be remembered that I'll say, and I'll accept. Yeah, it has to be remembered. But programming knowledge is not at all needed. Okay. So you can take my example itself. I'm an assistant professor in the mechanical department, which means, you know, like I've not studied computer science also. And in my plus one and plus two, computer science I have not touched. Even the textbook I have not touched. So right now I'm able to compile my entire thesis on it. So what has happened is I've started using it. Then as day proceeds, I've been using it. I've gained some knowledge using Google, Google searching, and then learned new stuff. And okay. That's it. Okay, so the answer is no.
Okay, sir. So, right, so if we prepared a document, if we prepared a Word document, is there a possibility of export that to LaTeX?
No, sir. Online tools are there wherein you can convert your Word document into a text document. But the problem is you'll have lots of problem in it. The formatting won't be correct. So what I would suggest is if you have something, you can copy it and paste it. Okay, so that is how I actually do. If I prepare a document in LaTeX, basically I don't type, in LaTeX the entire thing. Even my thesis, the first thing that I've done is I've typed it in Word. Then I'll go to LaTeX, prepare everything, ensure that, that page setup is kept, the distance between the paragraphs is set, everything is set. Once I've set that completely, just copy paste. That's it.
Okay.
Okay. So we'll start with, is there any other doubt? Right. LaTeX and Overleaf, both are one and the same, sir. LaTeX is basically a combination of two things. One is a compiling software, and another one is basically an editing software, which you have installed in your system. Whereas Overleaf, you're not going to install anything, but everything is done in the online mode. So whatever you do in Overleaf, you can copy it, paste it in LaTeX, it will work. And similarly, whatever you do in LaTeX, you copy it, paste it in Overleaf, that will also work. The difference is this. Overleaf is the online mode. You don't have to install anything. LaTeX, you have to install it in your system, and you don't have you don't need any internet connection to work on it. That's it, sir. I cannot say Overleaf takes care of everything. So this is what I told in the beginning also. Overleaf is basically a paid version. Okay, you can use it as a freeware. But if you try working on your research documents, as I told you, this will go into the public domain. So if anyone finds this particular research work that you have done in the public domain, there is a high percentage of those people copying it, and then they can publish it. But if you don't want that to happen, you have to put some money and then buy it. Yes, sir. Overleaf takes care of both compiling and editing. Okay, so that is how it goes. For LaTeX, you can use Overleaf. But my recommendation is basically this. Please do not learn LaTeX using Overleaf. But when you're typing anything related to your research, please never use Overleaf at all. Because once you save it, it directly enters into the public domain. Anyone can view. And if they view, yes. 100%, sir. Yes, you can do it in Ubuntu also. I have used all the three softwares. It works in Windows. It works in Ubuntu. It also works in Linux. No issues at all. All right. So what is the difference between LaTeX and Evernote? Evernote is also an editing software, but Evernote is basically not a standalone software. You need to combine it with Word. Evernote, if I'm so sure, Evernote is basically have to be combined with Word, and then only it will work in the proper fashion. It is actually a referencing kind of tool that is used in Word. Yes, first you have to install MikTeX, and then you have to install TextMaker, then only it will work right. Okay, so I think I've taken a lot of questions. So we'll start with it. And if questions are there, please hold it on to it. At the end, we'll get to the answers. All right, so I'll start with, this particular Word document, right? Then I'll copy it, paste it in my LaTeX, which I've installed. Then you'll see how it goes. Fine. Right, so this... I'll erase everything, then I'll start with it. Right. Okay. First thing, this is how you can start working with it. So the first question when you start a document is what document you're going to type. Okay. Sometimes it will be a thesis. Sometimes it will be a journal article. Sometimes it will be a proceeding article. And sometimes it may be a letter, because you have something that is called as letter in some journals also. Okay. So these are the documents that you can type it. So the first thing that you have to do in a LaTeX document is specify what is the document class you're going to type. Okay. So in LaTeX, every command will start with a small backslash. Okay. If you do it, it by, you know, by itself will tell, you know, give you some suggestions. First thing I've told, please mention the document class. So you can just type document. Once you type DO, Overleaf will basically tell you this is the command that is best suited for you. Okay. So you have the first command and then you have the second command. Okay. The first command and the second command are basically one and the same. Document class and the second command also has document class. But the first command has a square bracket and also a curly parenthesis. Whereas if you look into the second option, you just have a parenthesis. I'll tell you what is the difference. Okay, I'll go to the document class, first option, right? And then I'll type 12PT. Next place, I'll type article, right? What is that 12PT? So, just a second. Right. So your 12PT basically means that the letters that are present in your document has a font size of 12, as simple as that. Okay. By default, LaTeX will take it as 12, and in certain documents, certain journals, they'll be asking you to go for 10 points to keep the font size as 10. So that particular 12PT, 10PT, sometimes 8PT, sometimes 14PT, sometimes 13PT, all these things are there. So that will tell you what is the font size that you have to use, right? But another thing that I'll tell you over here, but I'm not going to tell the solution in this particular session, but it will be there in your YouTube video. In LaTeX, 10 point is there. Font size of 12 is there. Next, you get 12 point, 12 font size. Next, you get it as 14. So sometimes in certain places, especially in my thesis, in my college, they have told me to use 13 point. 13 point by default, it is not there in your LaTeX document. But is it a very big headache? No, not at all. That can be included. You can do a small modification and then you can include it. Okay. But this, I cannot cover it as of now. So let me just tell, yeah, it can be taken care. The solution will reach you through your through the YouTube videos. Okay. So I'll keep it as 12 point and then it is an article, right? Fine. Next, once you have an article, obviously you're going to have a title, right? So you can go put a backslash stating that it is a command, and then you can just type TI. It by default will give you a few suggestions, and the first suggestion itself is title. Okay, so I'll click on title. Got it. So title over here is we'll put it as first attempt, right, completed. So once you're going to submit an article to the journal, you have a title. The next one is author. Okay, so slash AU. So here again you have two options for authors. I'll go to the second option. We'll just give one name, so Ajay Vasan, right? That's it, done. So you have given your title, you have given your author page, and then if date is required, you are going to use it, but we'll see it later. Okay, that's it, completed. Now after this, you will be again using a slash, and then you will say begin document, right? So this is how it works in LaTeX. If you are going to go for a table. Okay. So you say begin table and end table. And if you're going to insert a figure, again you have a begin figure and end figure. If you're going to have an equation, again you have that begin equation, end equation. Okay, so what happens in LaTeX is everything, just a second. One of you have asked this particular question. I'm using TextStudio. If you're using TextStudio, no problem. Don't install all these things. I think it will be working fine with you. So don't install and then complicate yourself. Continue with your synopsis. Do not install MikTeX. Okay, sorry for that interruption. So everything that you type will have a begin document and an end document. Okay, so a begin and then an end, right? So whatever you have typed before the begin document is not a part of a document. Okay, basically you have classified, mentioned some formalities in that particular document. Once you put that begin document, end document, within that particular begin and end only, everything should be there. The content of the whole article will be present between that begin and end document only. Okay, so please have that in your mind and then we'll start, right? So I've typed all these things. I've told what is the title. I've told what is the author. Then I've told the begin document, end document. I'll compile it. So this is what the one person has asked. This has some error, right? So you can, if you want, you can look into all these things, but you'll have some issues. The error is this thing, make title. So this is where the error occurs. Okay, so you have begin document, end document. Okay, if you just use that in online mode, you'll get an error. Whereas if you just do it in the software installed in your system, you're not going to get any error. Why that error happens is based on the code that they have written. But make title is the command that is used basically to insert your title and your author. Okay. I'll just copy the entire thing. I'll go to the software that is installed in my system. I'll erase the whole syntax. And again, I'll paste this particular document. The first thing that you have to do is save this. Then only it will be working. So I'll save. Save it. So here, first you have to compile it. So this, you can find it over here. That should be selected. You have n number of things that are present. A few things we'll be seeing, a few things won't be able to see. But as of now, just select PDF LaTeX and press this button over here. It'll get compiled. It shows it has been compiled. Then you can go for view PDF, right? So I want you people to note down something over here, both in the document that is developed in the compiled in the software that is installed in my system, as well as this software, which is in the online mode. First attempt is the title that we have given. Author, I've given my name. But you can find the date which is appearing by default. Okay, so this will be an issue sometimes. So how to overcome it? We'll put just slash date and we'll compile it once more. Then you can see the date doesn't appear. Okay, so this if you type an article, higher possibility is that your date will be appearing. Okay, the current date when it is compiled. Okay, so if you use this particular command slash date curly parenthesis, what happens is your entire date will be removed out. So this also works in your installed software. So what you have to do is just put backslash date curly parenthesis, save it, compile it, and then if you view that particular document, your name will not appear. Okay. Right. So one person has asked invalid environmental command in pink color while giving the command begin. Yes, you have to give that particular make title. If you don't give that make title, your title won't be appearing. Your title, authorship, all these things will not be appearing at all. Make title is a must. Whether it's an installed software or whether you're using ShareLatex, you have to give that particular option as make title. Okay. And another question, I'm not able to get the question. Invalid environmental command in pink color while giving the command begin. Don't worry about it. Just type the entire thing. That particular error will be vanishing off. Okay. So even I think I'll be getting that particular error. / begin. So if I have not selected it properly, obviously it's going to appear. Right. Fine. So now we have seen how you should be starting with it. Fine. So after the title, let me say that you are going to type something. I'll say this is the first document. Sorry for the spelling mistake. Document that we have typed and compiled in the LaTeX environment. Right. So once you have done this, just compile it. You'll get the desired case. Okay. So as I told you, this will be automatically justified, right? So you don't have to worry about it. Fine. Now, so what we have seen in the previous class yesterday is you have something as headings. Heading 1, heading 2, heading 3, heading 4, etc., etc. Here also that is made possible. Okay, but how to? So let me say that we are writing a journal article. So the first heading is going to be introduction. The second heading is going to be literature survey. And under literature survey, you have some subheadings. Okay. So how you can introduce those things, get to the source code, right? So / for sure. Then you can use this command section. Okay. So section is basically referring to the first heading in Word document. So this becomes your introduction. Okay. Compile it. By default, the number will be given and then you can see the introduction part. Okay. So after this, then you can type this is the place where you can type your introduction, right? Fine. So you have your introduction part. Whatever is required in the introduction part, let me assume you have typed it. So the next heading is literature survey, right? So as usual, / you use the command section and then you go for literature. So again, you compile it. By default, you'll have this particular literature. So under literature, you're going to have a subheading that is referred as subsection. So / subsection is the command. So this is the subheading under literature. Please don't mind the spelling mistake that I make. Again, if you compile it, by default, you can find the subheading has been created. Let me say that you have another heading under this. Okay. Then it is subsection. Okay. So this is under the previous section. So if you compile it, then you'll be getting this as 2.1.1. Okay. So now I think you should have wherein basically whatever should be there in that first heading, your introduction, your literature, conclusions, results and discussions, whatever it may be. Even under that, if you have a subheading, then you go for something that is called as subsection. Okay. Some of you may have this particular doubt. What if I do have another heading under that? Okay. Let me say that this one. Under the previous section, you have another heading after that. So basically, the number should be 2.1.1.1. But if I'm so correct, none of the journal or none of the book chapters and even thesis of any university will go to that particular level. It is basically level number 4 that no university will do it. No book chapter, no journal will be doing it. But let me say, even if you have it, then basically you will not be using any numbers. So what you do is you use this option called as paragraph. Okay. So this paragraph is used for headings starting from level number 4. And anything which is after level number 4, which is level number 5, etc., etc. So thesis, book chapters, as well as journal articles will never allow you to go after level 3. Very rarely, even you guys will be having level 4, level 5 or level 6. If that is the case, use this paragraph option. So this will be used for headings starting from level 4 and beyond. So if you compile it, then you can see this. Okay, it's not going to have any numbers, but it'll be just bold and other things will be there, right? So this is how your document will be formatted with, right? So this is just an, right? So how to copy your contents from your Word document. Just a second. The name of Overleaf is one place where it is much more simple. Okay, so you can actually relate your Overleaf with the installed software. There are also other places wherein you can use online LaTeX, but those online LaTeX places basically will be differing. It will have some difference between the software and the installed system. So I recommend you people to learn LaTeX using this Fair LaTeX, right? Yeah, why the font size is reducing in sub and subsections after they are compiled? And the next question, are we allowed to change the font type in this? Yes, you can change all these things without any issues. But as I told you, please wait. I'm not going to end the session after this. I'll tell you how to insert the figure and the table data. Please wait. Your font size, your font type, everything can be changed. Okay. But the only problem is that will require some extensive way of, moving forward with the session. So please wait for it. But I promise that I cannot tell it in this particular session with this just 1 hour of duration. I'll promise that after 2 days, I'll send you the YouTube video link. You can use that. There I'll show you how to change all these font size. Right. So next thing is, copying it from a Word document. Let me just open a Word document so that it's simple for me also to explain with. Okay. Right, let me just open this particular document. This is my journal article that I have written. So let me just use it. 1 second. It will take some time for me to open it. Okay, so this is the Word document that I've used. Okay, so I have my abstract, I have my introduction, etc., etc. Fine. So what I'll do is I'll copy my title over here and I'll just replace. I'm sorry, I'm not doing this, you know, copy paste thing in the online mode. So as I told you, it will go public as soon as I save it. So I don't want to risk my research work. So I'll just tell it in the software. So I'll just paste it, the title over here. So as I told you, abstract will be a part of it. So this will be going under the section over here. Abstract. Next thing, I'll go to the Word document. I'll copy the entire abstract. And I will paste it over here. Okay, I'll save it, compile it, and I'll run it. There you have. So I have my abstract. Again, here you will be able to find abstract should not have a number, but here it is appearing one abstract. Okay, you can remove it, but the problem is time. Let me say time dependency. I will not be able to tell it. I'll promise the YouTube videos will be reaching you, right? So the next section is obviously my introduction. So I'll go to section intro. Let me just stop with this. So you can go to your Word document. You can copy the entire thing, but as of now, I'm just copying the first paragraph, save it, compile it, and then you can. Okay, so now you have abstract as the first heading, second heading is introduction, and then it'll be followed by the paragraph that you have, and finally, you have your abstract also. As I told you, abstract, you have this number one that should be removed. So you can go to this particular section over here. I'm sorry, where abstract is present. So just after section, add this particular symbol hash. Now we can find it out. Okay. So if you just use section, okay. So what happens is, you will get the numbers by default. Okay, introduction, literature, survey, etc., etc. But after section, before that, you know, curly parenthesis, if you include this particular, you know, star symbol, as simple as that, if you include this particular star symbol, what happens is that some of your questions, copy it. Okay, fine. Let me just read the questions. Sir, is available? Is it sufficient to us? Yeah, it is available in online, but again, it is a repetition. Please don't do it in online. Your whatever you have typed will go to the public domain. If it is a confidential research document, obviously you'll have some issues. What is the difference between a command with square, box, and parenthesis, and command only with parenthesis? Okay, so if you have a square bracket, yeah, I think the other person has answered it. Square bracket is actually a special case. So if you use square bracket in the case of document class, you're telling about the font size. Please tell slowly as how to save and compile in Overleaf. Yes. That I'll tell you. The next question, how to change margin and indentations? Yes, you can change your margins and indentations. Everything can be changed in LaTeX, but this particular session I cannot say. I'm sorry, the time is not there. So I'll just tell you what are the basic things that are required in LaTeX. You can practice it, but before, you know, 2 days, I'll ensure it reaches you for sure. How to start in the download version? If you're going to start in the download version, very simple. The same thing what I've showed in this, you know, share LaTeX. First thing is you are going to tell what is the document class. Followed by that, you'll have your title. Followed by that, you'll have your authorship. Followed by that, this command slash date will be used to remove of the date. And then begin document, end document by default, make title will be there. Okay. Up then you can, you know, type in whatever comes in for your requirement. No, in offline mode, you're not going to get any suggestions. The next thing is, if you're going to use a foreign language, yes, it supports foreign language, but you have to install that particular library before that. Yes, do we have a proper book of step-by-step procedure in LaTeX software? No, it is not available in any sort of book. But once this particular session ends, already I have sent a zip file to Daniel sir. That zip file will be shared with you. So that zip file basically is, you know, for you people to play with LaTeX. Okay, so you can unzip it and then you can extract it and then you can play with it. Fine. Okay, so let me just start with this particular video session. So I've answered that particular question. You just have to copy, paste it. Control C, Control V. That's it. Nothing is going to change. Once you do it and compile it and then, you know, do it, everything is going to work fine, right? So one person has asked how to save it in this particular, you know, LaTeX document and how to recompile it. You don't have to save it, sir, and you don't have to recompile it. Both is done simultaneously. Okay. Let me say that, you know, I'm typing something, you know, abruptly over here. Right. Either you can press Control S. Once you press Control S, it will save and automatically it will compile and then give you the answer. Okay. Or again, I'll remodify the document. If you press recompile, it compiles, gives you the output as well as saves it. Okay. So if you want to remodify it later, you don't have to work on anything. By default, it will be saved with the heading as video session. Okay. So you don't have to worry about those things.
Oh, sir?
Yes.
Every journal has a different kind of submission, no, sir?
Yes,
so
sir.
We can edit as per the requirement or what?
Yes, sir. That also I'll show. This is one journal which I'm trying to, modify it. Just give me a moment or so. I'll get into the journal page and then show how it works. That also I'll show it to you.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
So this is one journal. Please don't mistake me. Since I'm from the engineering background, I'm just opening an engineering journal, again from my field, which is mechanical. But I can assure you that these things are there in almost, all the journals, right? Okay. So I've just gone to the journal page. I think I've downloaded. Let me just check. I'm not able to find it. But every journal will give you that particular text document itself. You don't have to worry about it. You're not going to type anything, basically. How, you know, that should be aligned, all those things, formatting of your document, everything will be given. I'm just searching for it so that if I find it, it will be easy for me to tell it to you. I think this is the document. No. Right. I think it will take some time. But yes, this I can tell it to you for sure. Certain documents or certain journals will give you the LaTeX document itself. So that will have .tex as, you know, as the extension. The only thing is you have to download it and then work on it, right? Just give me 1 second. I think I have it in another place. Yes. Yeah. Great. Okay, so this is what I've been telling you. So this is for a IEEE transactions. Okay, so you don't have to work on anything very tedious. Everything by default is given there itself. So once you open it and then download it, you'll be having all these stuffs, right? So if you are very well, you know, sure of how to use your Python and how to use your LaTeX, obviously you'll be able to use this with ease. You don't have to, you know, burden yourself with rewriting it according to the necessary thing. Okay, yes, it is there. This is just an example. Okay, so this is there in the IEEE transaction page itself. So I think this might answer one of your questions, you know, that has been raised. Right. So let me just finish it. I'm thinking I'll take another 15 minutes. Sorry for taking the time also. Right. So one person. Has asked how to equation. Very, very useful when you have a lot of mathematical equations. I'll show how this becomes useful. Right. Fine. So let me say begin, and I'll. As I told you, everything will have a begin and an end. So right now I'm going to write an equation. So slash begin is the command. And then within that parenthesis, I'm going to go for equation. Right? So as soon as I type it, you'll be able to find begin equation and end equation is there. Okay. So one person has asked a question in the beginning, whether you should be, you know, knowing programming, you know, knowledge. You should have a programming knowledge, a background to a work on LaTeX? No, but if you are going to write in equations, then you have to remember certain stuffs. Okay. If you are going to use special symbols, okay, this I think will be applicable for people who are working in mathematics as well as mathematical, you know, background in mathematical applications in engineering. Okay. So let me say you have a symbol alpha, right? So alpha is equal to beta is equal to C. This is what you're going to write. Okay. So slash alpha is equal to slash beta is equal to slash gamma. I'm sorry. I made a mistake over here. Gamma and alpha. Spelling mistake, sorry. I compile it. Here you can find the equation has come into picture. Alpha is equal to beta is equal to gamma. Okay. So how is that I'm remembering this? Very simple. Let me say that you Google equations in LaTeX. You will be able to find everything over here. Let me go to the second link. Fine. So if you're going to use your equations. Wow. Yeah, you have this over here. Okay. So not equations. I'm sorry. Symbols in LaTeX. And here it is given to you as a whole. Yes. So if you have alpha, how to use it, gamma, how to use it, mu, etc., etc., sum of all these things are given over here. The only thing is, as I told, this will take a hefty amount of time. If I tell, very frankly, 1 hour will take, you know, exclusively of telling how to use your equations. Okay. Let me just tell one more place of how to use the equations. With that, I'll stop. Okay. So let me say I have another equation. I'll type it first. So begin equation. Begin equation. So now what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to use, let me finish it off, then I'll say. So alpha is equal to sum and then up to n equal to 1 x underscore I. I think this particular equation is most common for people who are working in management also. Okay. So this particular sum, or let me say, this is also sometimes referred as integration. This particular symbol is very well, you know, used in many places. Let me just zoom it. Right. So this particular symbol, you know, sigma, that is represented as sum. Okay. And then on top of sum, you have this number n. So that is represented by using this, you know, I don't know how to, you know, tell it, but this particular, you know, let me say upper arrow is used. And then you have curly parenthesis. Within that, I write n. So whatever I write within that particular, you know, curly parenthesis, n or n minus 1 or whatever it is, that will appear. So let me just make a small change. N minus 1 I write. So if I recompile it, what will happen is this particular n at the top will be coming as n minus 1. Right. I'll explain, then I'll recompile it. Then I put an underscore and then I type, within curly parenthesis, I type I is equal to 1. Underscore means this particular I is equal to 1. So below that something should be there, right? So this is what is present in underscore, or this is what your underscore does. Okay. And then I have X and then in the subscript I have I. Okay. So this is what is present over here. X underscore I will mean that I have a normal X and in the subscript I have I. Okay. But again, let me say, if it is going to have another subscript, subscript J. Recompile it. Now we can particular case. Okay. So what has happened over here is N minus 1 has been introduced. Similarly, you have another subscript J that also has come into picture. Okay. So there is an error. This can be removed using this I and J. So this is how I don't want to use, you know, I don't want to give any numbers to this equation. So here, this is that line where I've typed it. So you have slash begin. Just after equation, use this small asterisk symbol, recompile it. Automatically, your first equation will be in line with this. And then you're not going to have any sort of equation number. Okay. How to give references and table. Wow, you have n number of questions over here. Tell about figure and table. Yeah, that I'll tell it. Let me get back. First, I'll tell about figures and tables. Then I'll get back to that software as a whole. So, 1 second. Yes. I'll get back to this document which I've shared with you. Just give me a moment. I'll compile it and then tell you. Other questions are how to give references and tables, how to use superscript. Yeah. Equations, it will take some amount of time. I'll take another few minutes and then I'll tell you. You already told writing synopsis after Steven. Right, so Inderpreet, there's one thing. Generally, if you're going to copy and paste everything from your Word document, yeah, you can do it. No harm in doing it. But one thing has to be made very clear. If you're doing a referencing in Word document, obviously, in LaTeX, if you copy paste it, it will have some issues. You cannot modify it. But the problem is, let me say, referencing, if you're doing it in LaTeX itself, you cannot copy and paste the entire document. You have to make some modifications, right? Very good. What does that percentage symbol mean? Percentage symbol means basically it is not going to execute that particular line. It's not going to compile that particular line. So if you have to give any comment, let me say I've introduced a special character. I have to give a comment to it. So then I use a percentage symbol just to give a comment for it. Right. So this is the document that you people will be getting it. Fine. So let me just get to it. You can play with it. But let me tell all those things that comes over here. Right. This is not an article. So if we look into the beginning over here, document class, A4 paper size is being used. And this is actually a book. So if you're telling that, you know, it is going to be a book, 100% you can take it for guaranteed. You're going to have chapters within that particular book. Okay. One special thing, I'm not going to tell it as of now. I'll tell you, there's something that is called as packages. Okay. Basically meaning like ask whether I can go for other, you know, languages, French or German or whatever it is. Yes, you can go, but you should be installing a library. That is basically a package. Okay. And another one, and a few others asked me, sir, can we change the font size? Can we change the indentation? Yes, everything can be done. For that, I have just created this particular, you know, page option over here. I'll open this and then I'll show it to you also. So this is the document. If you extract it, all these, you know, contents which are present will be appearing for you. Okay. So this one on the left hand side. So under attachments, the folder, you'll be having basically the attachment, which is like if you have to attach a figure or whatever, even videos can be attached. So that will be there. Then you have contents. Leave the contents is not a matter. Then you have figures. So if you have to insert a figure, for instance, that will be present over here, literature. And then I have settings. So under settings, again, I have another set of, you know, text command that will be present. So I'll just open one and then I'll show you. But the entire detailed explanation of what each line will be doing, you'll be getting it. Right, so this is what I have told you. If you are going to use a special set of a language, then you need to use something that is called as use package. Okay, and as I told you, everything in this particular LaTeX document obviously will be justified, but that also will have inherent problem. But how to overcome that particular problem? All these things I have mentioned. I have written code for this. So if you feel like using it, you can use it by default. Again, I have shared it with Daniel, sir. He'll be sharing it with you. But as I told you, 1 hour is very difficult for LaTeX. In the YouTube video, I'll explain why this particular line has been used. For example, enumerate. Okay, so this is a package that is used for a certain purpose. Why this package is being used, everything I'll tell you in detail, line by line. Right, so let me get back to this main document. Right, so this is a book. So you're going to have, as I told you, title, author, date, make title. I've given everything. So the first chapter over here is chapter 1 and its basics. So chapter, basics, then page style fancy. Again, this is very, very difficult for me to dwell it in just 1 hour. Just get a hold of it. Later, you'll understand it for sure. Okay. So page style, there's something, word fancy I've introduced. And then you have the entire set. So as I told you, section is being used. So you'll have this particular section, heading over here. So this particular command, IMP. So that is where you have an emphasis being placed on the Word document. Then you have something that is called as blind text. Okay. And then let me get back to the one that is very important. Right. So here, how to work on your mathematical stuffs. Okay. So that I have typed it over here. I forgot to tell one most important thing. Let me say, this is the place where you have typed. This is the PDF you have. Okay. Let me say that, you want to see how this particular equation has been typed. What are the symbols? But if you have to get to the exact place in this, LaTeX document, it's very difficult. So what you can do is go to this particular line, press Control in the case of Windows. And jump to it. Okay. How to deal with your mathematical stuff. So some of you asked about, superscript, other stuff. Everything is explained in detail over here. So how to use your equations in math mode, your arrays, if you have matrices, and your mathematical fonts. Okay. So your super fonts, your mathematical symbols, everything will be there. The third chapter will talk about your hyperlinks. So how to include your hyperlinks, everything again is given in detail. If you have to give a URL, okay, so if I just click this, how your this particular URL will directly take me to that particular web page. So how to install all these things, your literature. So one person has asked me how to convert the synopsis, copy paste, that those issues, all those things will be addressed in this particular literature reference. Okay. And then how to insert and work with your tables. Okay. So here I have, this is basically a difficult one to get a hold of it. I'll just still understand it. And then if it is, very confusing, just go through it. In the meantime, once you go through it, within a max of 3 to 4 days, you'll get the video also. So it'll be useful. Okay. So here, this is the figure that is present. The line starts from over here. I've selected it. So slash begin figure. And obviously you're going to have it as end figure, right? And after that figure, a square bracket is used, and then I've used something, hashes, and then I've used H. That has a specific meaning, okay? So your LaTeX document, if you compile it, if you do not use this particular symbol, your figure will be placed randomly within the document, okay? So sometimes your figure should be placed at the top of the document. Sometimes it should be placed exactly at the end of the document. Sometimes at the mid of the document. And in certain places, it should be placed exactly in the place where it should be placed. So this apostrophe H means it has to place the image exactly where I'm putting this begin figure. Right? So that is what the meaning is. Then the next line is centering. So what happens in this particular line is, if you're going to place an image, obviously it's going to be centered. A center alignment is going to be given. Okay. Next command is include graphics. Right. So this particular include graphics is used mainly to, introduce the figure into the document. Here copy paste won't work. Okay. So if you're going to introduce a figure, first thing is, you have to use this include graphics, and then the next thing is you have to specify the width and the text width, right? Then you can find text width, and then width is within the square bracket. Okay, so this is optional. Anything within the square bracket is optional. Okay, you can also change it with other, syntax also. I'm not telling it what are the other syntax. I'll let you know in the later stage. Next thing, within the curly bracket. Okay, you have something called as figures. So if I if you actually download that particular file, zip file that you're going to get, and you extract it, there will be a folder figures, and in that particular folder figures you'll be able to find this particular file cube. So I've told the system, in this folder figures and the file cube, that should be included. Okay, so that has been included. The next one is caption. So here, there in the Word document, it is just right clicking and then you're going to give insert caption. But over here, this command is used, slash caption, and whatever should be the caption, you can do it. Next thing is label. Okay, so this particular label works together with something that is called as reference, that is given as slash REF. Okay, sorry, I'm not telling it in detail. So this particular figure, if it has to be given as a reference, here, over here, I have highlighted that slash auto ref, and then whatever I've named it, I've given it over here. So what has happened over here is this, if I change or include any new figure, figure number also will change. And this referencing with the hyperlink also will change. So that is the reason why you use your label as well as your reference or auto reference. Okay. And then how to insert your tables. So this table itself is again another big thing. So again, sorry for not telling it in detail. You can look into it, try to get a hold of it. As soon as you try to understand, within a, within 3 or 4 days, you'll get the video, so that that will be much more appropriate. Okay. So please, sorry for, you know, going it on a rush. Then you have how to use your enumerate option, 1, 2, 3, or if you have points, how to put all those stuffs will be available. And then your appendix, footnotes, to-dos, index. Yesterday, one of you asked me how to go for index. So indexing cannot be done in Word on an easier note. Over here, it will be easier. Okay. So again, how to do those appendix, references, all these things are put in detail. Okay, the only problem is you will not be able to understand it to a greater deal. Just Google it, try to get a hold of it. But I promise you, within 3 or 4 days, as soon as that, you know, YouTube videos related. To Word is uploaded, I'll give you the links for the LaTeX also. Okay, I'll stop with this. One of you have asked the question, how to introduce a layout, example power plant. That is also a figure, if I'm so correct. Okay, so if you I told that that I have used a LaTeX for preparing my thesis. Obviously, every thesis will have a layout of how your thesis is done. Okay, so yeah, that is a figure. So your same procedure that is used for introducing that figure will be used. Is it possible to conduct more lecture on LaTeX? If time permits, yeah, we'll try to take it up. But in the meantime, I promise that the YouTube videos will reach you for sure. Okay. So with this, I'll stop. I think I've taken more time. Tell about graph. Graph cannot be included directly. Your graph can be converted into a figure. Let me say, if you're going to use Excel for creating graph, or there are other softwares for creating graph, Tableau, R, MATLAB, for instance, or even Python, for instance. First, you have to save that as a figure, and you can only insert your figure. Okay. So in LaTeX, we can insert figures, tables only. Apart from that, equations, obviously. But apart from that, yes, overleaf. Will go to list, or even if you compile it, it will go public. So please don't use overleaf for your research purposes. Try to install it and then please use it. The next point is, like, you know, during plagiarism check by the institute, are we allowed to insert images like that? Yes. You can insert your graph. I've told I've done my thesis in LaTeX. Okay, so which means every thesis, being from the engineering background, obviously I'm going to have graph. It may be a line chart or a bar chart. Or basically, I do have graphs. Yes, your institute will allow you to use your graph as an image. No problem in that. So is there any other questions? I think it's very hard to digest. I do accept it is hard to digest. But as I told you, it's very, very difficult to complete it within a day. To tell very frankly, this is not the first time I'm taking a guest lecture on this particular LaTeX. I've already taken it. To tell it very frankly, it took one whole day to give just the introduction about LaTeX. So within 1 hour, it's very difficult. You'll get videos so that you get understand. You'll get a better understanding about LaTeX. So is there any other questions then? Thank you. Thank you. So I'll talk with Daniel, sir. Yeah. What I'll do first is, first I'll upload the video on Word. As soon as it reaches you, then I'll upload the videos on LaTeX. Please go through it, and maybe I think this particular session goes till July. Am I correct, Daniel, sir?
Yes, sir. July 15th. I think coming Friday morning, I will be handling class on Google Scholar and other thing. So on that day, if you possible, if you have a free time, you can have a take like lecture on that day, whether it is possible.
Oh, okay, that would be better. Coming Friday, right?
Yeah, yes, sir.
Okay, that would be better then. So I'll join the session. So as soon as Daniel sir finishes off,
You can take it for 1 hour, sir. 1 hour or
how much it goes. Okay, so we'll have it. He will have another session on LaTeX on Friday also. Okay, so I'll promise you this before Friday, the videos related to Word will reach you. And Friday, we'll have a small session again on LaTeX. Then the next Monday, the forthcoming Monday, videos related to LaTeX also will reach you. Okay. Sir, you. Daniel, sir, you have received that email that I have sent.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. That I will circulate in mail to everyone. Yeah.
Sure.
I think before 12, all will receive a mail regarding that LaTeX.
Okay, sir.
Okay, sir. Thank
right,
you so much.
So everyone, thank you and listen. Thank you. And I also thank everyone for listening, patiently. Some of you might have a little bit, you might have a headache after listening to this lecture. So take some rest, and again we'll meet on Friday.
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.